You have all gone through the first topics, that means nursing process, nursing assessment 1, health assessment part 1, part 2, part 3, nursing process. So today we are going to continue how you going to, put this nursing process into practice, integrating nursing process into practice. This is something that is usually what we are doing at the ward setup or in the clinical setup. So there's nothing much more to learn, but what we have to do is this is not about the local nursing, it's about the global nursing. So we should know what are the trends and what are the new things which can be, you know, used or utilized in our nursing sector. So we'll move on. The learning objectives will be you will be preparing a new nursing history form, which of course what we are not practicing in our setup. In our NTS time we have done much more nursing history forms, but not using in the normal practical setup. So there are so many special purpose assessments going on, we are going to talk about that, and there are so many characteristics which is related to the effective charting system, so we are going to continue our session regarding that. And there will be a comprehensive care plan preparation. Okay, now I like to talk with you all. So, in your words, what do you mean by a nursing record? Nursing record? What do you mean by a nursing record? Is there anything such special? Is there any separate document which the nurses are recording daily? Is there anything in the patient care? Yes. Of course, we are writing the nursing procedures and all our things in our BHT. Of course, the BHT, those papers are the ones that we are writing. That is where our nursing records are consistent. But in other countries, or even in our ICU setup, we have separate papers called as nurses' notes. Right? Other than these nurses' notes, are there any other notes which is doing by only nurses? No VPs or no consultants? Are there any records? What are those? Day and night reports. It should be written by a nurse. And what else? Temperature charts. All kind of what we call them is flow charts. Temperature charts, observation, end injury or whatsoever, everything. Input-output charts, everything flow charts. Those things has to be maintained by the nurse who's appointed to the shift or who's appointed to the patient. And nursing records should be tailor-made. That is the word what we are using. Tailor-made. What do you mean by the word tailor-made? Tailor-made means you can't use the same record of a patient to another patient. That is of course copy and paste. That is something we cannot do, because each and every patient's nurse's records should be different. Because you can't copy and paste each and every intervention, each and every procedure which you have done to a patient. That is why nursing records are always tailor-made ones. According to the demand or according to the client, the records will be changed. And when you are writing nursing records, you should get familiar with each place's particular standards and policies. It's different from, because in Sri Lanka we have public healthcare sector, private healthcare sector. Is it the same way when we are writing the nursing records? No, in private sector there are some other ways. In public sector there are some other ways. Why is that? What is the difference? Because of the institutional or organizational standards or policies are so different. Because in public healthcare sector we have this free healthcare, what we call these as free healthcare, but it is not, because indirectly we are the people who's paying for that, so it is not free actual. But in private healthcare sector you're gonna pay for each and everything, for the cotton swab you're gonna pay, for the alcohol swab you're gonna pay, and even for the gloves, examination gloves, you're gonna pay. So each and everything, so the care is so different from the public and private. Because that thing we're gonna pay and we're gonna take the care. in public healthcare sector, we are not going to pay straightly, but we're going to get free healthcare. So the nursing care plans or nursing records will be different. In public sector healthcare, in government hospitals, are we writing patient care plans daily? Are we writing? No. But we have learned it in our NTS time, in our education setup, we have learned each and everything, what are the, what are the diagnosis part, what are the related factors, how we gonna write this as evidence part, how to write the proper nursing diagnosis, what are the interventions, what are the rationale behind each and every intervention, and how to evaluate everything. We have got the idea through our education setup, but we are not using it in our practical setting in Sri Lanka. Why? What is the reason? It's because we don't have time. Because we have a limited time and a whole lot of patient in the ward to care. If we go for the documentation, of course the care will be reduced. Because nurse-patient ratio is so high, 300 to 1. If you count all the patients and divide it by all the nurses, of course it will be 300 to 1. So, per day you can't do each and every patient's work and write each and every patient a care plan. Of course, we are unable to do because of this heavy workload that we are having. So, in private sector healthcare, is there anyone from the private sector? Yes. Do we have a separate paper called nursing care plans? In some hospitals, we are practicing it. At the end of each shift, we have to write a care plan. We have to get the assessment. We have to at least have 4 or 5 nursing goals and interventions. And each and every shift, there is a place to get the patient's signature, whether the nurse has done all these to you or not. Nursing records are always legal documents. If a patient is coming out from the hospital, we have to provide each and every document that we had in the hospital to the patient. I mean, not this full BHD, not the what do you call these doctor's notes, even the nursing care plans. But in foreign countries, when you are going out, when you are discharging, you have to provide the nursing care plan to the patient. Through the care plan, he might ask questions. You have mentioned that you have done this intervention to me, but you haven't done it to me. You have write it, you have already written it, but it is not has happened to me. There are so many things. That means nursing care plans are always legal documents. People can argue with that document. That is a legal one. Even it can be taken to the courts. So nursing records are essential if you are giving a proper care to the patient, and it is up to the patient's right to get to know whether am I receiving the proper care which I am paying for or which I am supposed to have inside the hospital. And it says nursing records should be done timely. What do you mean by the timely? Word timely. You can't write it after doing the procedure, after 3 or 4 hours, you can't update the records. Once you have done the procedure, at the same moment you have to write it there. Because it is not like letter writing. You can't say PTO, turn the other page and see whether I have written the share, what you call this, taking over, handing over and giving over things. You can't write it separately by putting backdated times or backdated days. What you have to do is, once you have done anything to the patient, at the moment you have to document it. That is a nurse's accountability. That is nurse's responsibility. Due to this quality, there are so much more problems that is happening, not to the patient, but also for the nurses. Nurses may have gone to courts because of their lack of writing these things. in the BHD or in the nurse's notes. There are so many things has happened in Sri Lankan history that due to this lack of writing, and you may have done the procedure, but you have not written in there. Imagine that how many errors that can occur to a patient here. We'll take the procedure as medication. Medication administration, you have administered an antibiotic or something else, but you forgot to write it, but you forgot to mark it. What will happen to the next shift or the next nurse who's taking care of that patient? There are so many medication errors. There are so many treatment errors that has happened because of small mistakes. That is why nursing records should be timely written things. It cannot be backdated, or you can't write it separately after all these things has happened. And there are so many nursing records that we can find in today's work. Some of them are, of course, nursing history form. Do we have a nursing history form in our practical setting? No. We only have medical history form. We'll discuss what is the difference between medical history and taking this nursing history. There are lots of differences. Now what we are confusing is about this medical history and whether the nursing history is the same or not. We'll talk about that. So nursing history form comes as the prominent part in nursing records. Then comes nursing care plan, of course, what we are writing. And nurse's notes separately. Flow sheets, medication, input, output, observation, those things come under flow sheet. And discharge summary. Discharge summary is another legal document which you have to prepare at the discharge. I mean, we are going to plan the discharge at the moment of the admission. But when the discharge has been done, when there are so many steps to be followed, we have to remove the cannula or the tubings and everything, and we have to check whether the cannula site has any inflammation or not, whether the tubing sites are having any oozing or bleeding or not, anything. And how you gonna give the follow-up details, whether you have given it or not, whether you have handed over all the documents to the patient or not. There are so much more things to be considered at the discharge. So it is also a nursing document, a nursing record, which we called as discharge summary. But what we have these days is discharge checklist, a seal. That we're gonna put a small signature, we're gonna tick off and give the discharge. That is not the discharge summary. Discharge summary is something different. There are so many things that has to be written in a discharge. Talking about documentation. Documentation means, of course, the written evidence. Evidence of what? If it's a written evidence, evidence to prove what? What is the thing that we're going to prove through nursing records? What is the thing? Monadapi oppu karanne yanne. Is there any Tamil one? Okay. Can you understand Sinhala? If I explain it in Sinhala, if you don't mind, I'll explain it in Sinhala also. That is our mother tongue, of course. So, what we going to prove through a nursing record? What we have done, whether we have done it in a good way or a bad way. Everything should be there. Is it up to you or the VP or someone else, whoever's included in the care of the patient, we have to document what has happened to him under our care. Because you are the one who is responsible for his life. Whether it goes to live more or going to death. It's up to you. Because you are the one who is taking the responsibility of all. So, documentation means the written evidence the interaction between nurse, patient, who else? All the other healthcare team. That is the written evidence which shows that this patient had interactions with these kind of people. It can be either nurse, VP, consultant, ward demo, who else? Physiotherapist, surgical, medical laboratory scientist, MLT with investigation, radiologist, whosoever, who's there for the patient care. That healthcare professionals or the healthcare team members. The document shows the evidence of the interaction. That is what it explains. And is that all? No. If the family is there, of course we are providing a family-centered care. By the name, we are providing a family-centered care. Ehema ne ape patient care walata api kiyanne client-centered and also family-centered care. We are not providing individualized care. We are providing a holistic care which is approaching all these environment which is around the patient and also the family who is around me. So this document should show each and everyone's interaction with the patient. That is why documentation is there and it is the written evidence to prove each and every interaction. And the administration of test, of course, documentation shows us what? The QHT input, output and everything. It gives us the statistical details regarding patient. It shows about the test and their results and the special procedures which has done to the patient or the treatment which has given to the patient and also the education. What are the instructions, follow-up instruction or health education sessions which has given to this patient has already been there in the document. You can't prove it by voice record.
Health education,
you can't say something like that. You have to write what are the health education tips which you have given to the patient. Because what we are doing at the hospital is preventive and curative care. Curative is already done by this administrating medication, everything. But preventive part should be administered through this health education. Preventive is not there anymore. Because we are always writing health education given. So what are the tips that you have given? For a diabetic patient, you can write at the care plan health education given. So what you have given as the health education? You might say,
CV kandepa, farm kandepa, katubat kand. Is that health education?
Is that what you mean by health education? No. Those are like advisors. Advisors are so different from health education. Health education is not the meaning of eat red rice, don't eat this, don't eat that. That is do's and don'ts. Those are not health education. Health education is something so different. You have to explain from the pathophysiology of the diabetic till the treatment methods and what are the preventive. That is health education. You have to cover the full scope. But when you are explaining it, it should be in a simple way, whether the people, I mean, to understand, in an understandable way, whether the people won't be able to understand it if you explain it in all scientific words. Diabetes, people will get, I mean, if you say insulin, alpha cells, beta cells in the pancreas, everything, he won't understand. You have to explain it in a very simple way.
And what else are there in the nurse's records? The results of a client's responses, diagnostic tests and intervention.
Have you ever seen that
we are coloring sometimes with the antibiotics and everything, how these fever spikes are going on? What are the responses to the antibiotics? So those things are also there. When you look at it, of course you know what is the response for each and every treatment. Imagine now the patient is suffering with hypothermia. If you have written as an intervention, tepid sponge given and inhalation, fever reduced or hypothermia reduced. Is that what you mean by nursing intervention or nursing diagnosis? Once you are doing an intervention, once you are doing something to the patient, there should be a meaning and the outcome should be explained properly. Hypothermia, then what is the temperature with the hypothermia? It should be 100 or 101 or something. Tepid sponge given, what is the duration of the tapiscon which was given to the patient. Fever reduced into what level? So otherwise, if you are not giving any evidence, you won't be able to explain fever reduced. Of course, your marks will be cut out in the exam. Of course, that is not a proper way to write an evaluation. Then you are writing an evaluation. Of course, you have to write it whether what has patient demonstrated at the very beginning and what have you done as a nurse and what was the outcome. Outcome should be measured in the
same way which you have measured the previous condition. So you should write, okay, body temperature reduced to 99. That's it.
So those kind of outcomes also there in documentation part. Everything is there. So whatever the things that has happened to the patient inside the hospital, everything is documented. I mean, that is the principle of documentation, but according to the workload and according to the nursing shortage, these things has been adjusted in a way that we can manage it at a ward. Otherwise, this is the main principle, or these things are must that has to be included in your nursing records. These are the main functions of nurses' records. What is the first one? It says nursing records or these patients' records provides a mode of communication. It is a mode of communication between whom and whom? Between whom? It is a mode of communication between nursing staff as well as all the other healthcare professionals. Because if you haven't written anything in the BHD at your shift, how the other nurse gonna take the shift and continue the care? Because you have not written anything. There are so many mistakes that is happening today because nurses who is giving over the shift is not writing properly. She is just by voice, she is telling this has to be done, CT scan has to be done, X-ray has to be. Who gonna say? Because we are human beings, we have this forgetfulness, that is our nature. So we won't remember each and everything that has to be done to the patient. That is why patient records or the documentation is there. So that is a mode of communication. Even though you are absent for the whole day, the next day when you come and take over the patient, you should get an idea what has happened to the patient by reading the BHD. That is why the BHD should be crystal clear, nothing should be cut off or scratched or anything, jumbled. Everything should be crystal clear. Even though you are so new to the ward setup after reading the BHD, you should know what has happened to the patient from the admission till now. So that is an advantage of writing a proper documentation or having proper documentation. So it is a mode of communication among healthcare professionals. Once you are dealing with the physiotherapist, you know what has the physiotherapist done previously. Physiotherapy will read the notes, what has previously done to this patient. Okay, chest physiotherapy given BD. Okay, that means I have to come twice a day if he is new to the ward or something. It is a mode of communication. That is why VP is writing. So under that you are also writing. VP may have given instructions, you may have done the test or anything what he has asked you to do, then of course the test results will come. It is just like a flow. Someone is starting and it is continuing by others. So it is a mode of communication. And the second one is, it provides information to evaluate and improve patient care. It might give you an idea whether this antibiotic has made any effect to the body temperature or not. Whether this antibiotic has made any effect to the wound healing or not. Because through the observation and through your records, you might know what has to be done to this patient in future. Whether we have to go in the positive side or whether into negative side. What is the progress which the patient is showing at the time when he is at the ward?
So those things can be taken out from the base. And the other one is, of course, main point considered as a legal document. Nursing notes or the documentations are always considered as legal documents. It can be taken to the courts. If the patient rights are there, imagine there are so many things that has happened. OT bed, in the operation theater bed, patient, imagine a death on the OT table. There should be so many things that has to be done.
What was the initial management when the patient has shown any attack or something? What has given? Is it atropine or not? If it's atropine, how many milligram? Who has given? Who has signed? Who has given the instruction to give atropine? Is it from a call or whether the VP has been there or not? Whether the surgeon has been there or not? And the theater nurse should be there. Each and everything that has happened should be written. And finally, the patient was expired due to some kind of thing. Otherwise, because the patient's family is not there to look each and everything, they might suspect. This death is suspected. Don't know, because we haven't seen, nurses and doctors were there, and finally, patient is dead. So there are so much complaints, because in Sri Lanka we don't have that kind of condition, but in foreign countries they have such highly valued things called as patient's rights. We don't have these patient rights at the moment in an active level. We do have, in the law system, we have patient's rights, but it's not in an active level. Because you can't even put a VP cuff to a patient without their consent. That is what we learned as informed consent. Informed consent is not only limited to surgeries or the procedures. It is something that you have to do each and everything. You can't take blood by force to a test. Atha digarinna? Atha mitamolo ganna? Aa mamme le ekak ganna yanne. But in patient rights, you have to explain for which test that you are going to take this blood and how you are going to take this, whether it is painful or not, what is going to happen. I am here, so reassuring is there, of course. So much more things has to be done. But due to this heavy workload, sometimes we are out of our mood. So we are there to provide the care, but that emotional or psychological parts are not has been added to our procedures. And panadol dekak denna. Ha yanna kakkumai dunna. And yanna nurses has been, you know, labeled as from a very bad word in this society. Why I mean, what is the difference between, I mean, why people are worshipping the VPs and the doctors who's there? Even nurses like their child to become another doctor. They never want their child to become a nurse. So who has created that logo, or who has created that remarkable signature of being so neglected in this society? So we have to change this thing. That is the reason we are doing this degree. Otherwise we don't have to who has to pay this much amount and do a degree within 2 years? Why? What is the reason? It's not because that you have to put BSc, HONS, OUM behind your name. That should not be the reason. You have to at least change this thing. Because otherwise we might end up being the same nurses, even though we are graduate in the same level, nurses. Because once I have said that... Because even the police officers, it was police officers before and it has become police karya now. And I'm glad we are nursing officers and we have not fallen into that level. But if it goes more, we will for sure be going to fall into a level like that. People are going to call us, you know, from that kind of work. We should not let that happen. Because nursing is not... what do you call this
autism. It is not. It is a basically scientific part, which we has to do. Because all the blame's gonna come to the nurse if we didn't do the documentation. We can't say we had a very heavy workload. No. We can't say. We should have this time management abilities more than other people in this world. Nurses should have this critical thinking, time management abilities more than anyone else in this world. Because nurses are born to be like that. And the other one is, of course, through these patient records, if we have maintained a very good record, it provides data for our education. Why? We can do retrospective research through the data. How this epidemiological unit gonna take all these statistics? By how? By going house to house to collect data? No. Through this patient's records. That is why we have a huge room in each and every hospital for patients' records. We are keeping till 5 years, right? It is for 5 years. We're gonna save all the documents for 5 years. Why? We need data for our statistical analysis as well as for our research. How are you gonna do a dengue research in Sri Lanka, in NHSL Colombo? What are the things that you're gonna see in 2016? Have you gonna find the details, all the statistical details of 2016? How many patients has came to NHSF with dengue fever and dengue hemorrhage? And who has been suffered till, I mean, who has been treated in ICUs? How many patients? From where are they? So all these details has to be there, because if we do our correct documentation, if we do our neat and tidy documentation, everything will be there for our educational purposes. So these are the things as what we have discussed. Documentation as a communication mode, and documentation can be used to evaluate the patient's progress, and also what has to be, what is missing there, how to fill the gaps. Those things can be taken out from this documentation. And it is called, I mean, it is a main legal document. If we talk about this legal standards, there are two things which is mainly comes under this nursing documentation. What is first one? Informed consent. In informed consent, we are not taking informed consent for each and every procedure. If we are giving IV, we are not going to take it. But in government setup or in private setup, what we are doing is informed consent is for the surgical, but informed consent itself is not limited for such, I mean, big procedures. It is for each and every procedure. Mandeng oyawa naawanne yanne mandeng oata bed bath ekak denne yanne ohoma inna puluwan washroom ekata yanna oneda mandeng oawa nebulize karanne yanne oyata ohoma inna puluwan. Nebulize kiyanne mokakda kiyala. I mean, sometimes people might not know anything. So it is up to us to give the informed consent, to inform them and take the consent whether he prefer to attend for the procedure or not. That is informed consent. And the other one is advanced directives. Of course, advanced directive is what? What is advanced directives? You have heard about last will, right? Last will, antima kamati patre. Advance directive means you are proposing someone to take decision on your health, right? So those are end of life kind of things. If you are unable to make decisions on your health, you're gonna propose someone else to stand there for you to make decisions about you. Sometimes that is why DNR is there. Do not resuscitate. Is it practicing in Sri Lanka? DNR? Due to this humanitarian things, it is not in an active level, isn't it? DNR, do not resuscitate. Is it there? Practicing in ICU. Who gonna sign for that? Consultant. Patients?
patient's family members, they will say DNR. But DNR can be written by the patient
when he is in full conscious level. It has to be written by them. Otherwise, we can't make decisions because the machines are so expensive and it is working for a longer period.
So, DNR cannot be done. DNR is a legal document.
That is why I said it is not in an, in a standard way. We are not practicing it in a standard way. We are maintaining it because we can't see. We are just like looking at the, it is kind of euthanasia. We are just like killing, the mercy killing. What we are doing here in Sri Lanka, it is not DNR, actually. We can't see that the patient is suffering a lot, so we gonna slowly kill the patient or something. We gonna switch off because he is not living anymore because of this machine that he is living here. DNR is something different. In advance directive means a competent client's ability to make healthcare decisions based on full disclosure. He can be taken his own decisions and as well as he can manage or he can give someone else to decide on him. So, advanced directives. So, those kind of things cannot be mistakenly document. If that thing has done, of course, it's up to the nurse. Each and everything has to be, I took this from even your book too. Because this is Malaysian law or something, because these advanced directives are here.
Last will is here in Sri Lanka also. Antima Tavati Patre. Antima Tavati Patre Vagetamai.
The other one is, of course, end of life care plan.
Jeevite Antimata Tirane Karakaneka. Thing, what do you call this? DNR is part of that. And one who is taking this, what do you call that?
Legal document. That is also a legal document. To decide what gonna happen to him at the end of life care. It is not about this palliative care. Palliative care is about this oncology and these things. But even a living person can make something like that. He can appoint someone to take decisions on him. My family member, my son will take decisions when I am not in a conscious level. If I am in a conscious level, of course I will decide. If I am not in a conscious level, my son will decide what should be happen to me. Those kind of things. So, even what are the documents that nurses are dealing with? Especially these death certificates. Yeah. If we have written the name in a wrong way or the BHT number or whatsoever, the address, everything is fully jumbled. That is why even these kind of things, last will. Imagine, if we have written it mistakenly, we can't call the person again. Right? Get up and just explain me what has happened here. Because those kind of things has to be done very carefully. That is why legal, when you are dealing with nursing documents, you should be in a full conscious level. Otherwise, you may end up having a last will at the last moment. So, these are advanced directives and this is what documentation as educational research. Talking about the nursing history form. We'll talk about nursing history form.
What is the difference between
nursing history form and medical history form? Is it different? Yes, it is different. It is totally different. We are not going to take what the doctor is taking. We are not going to repeat the same thing again in our form. In BHT, nothing should be repeated again and again from a nurse and a doctor. Right? What the, doctor is taking as in the medical history and what the nurse should take in the nursing history. Is it different? Yes. Different from medical history. It is recorded to identify the patient's problem. That is not...
What do you mean by this? Presenting complaint or past medical history, past clinical history? Those are not
going to be addressed in the nursing history form. What we are writing is wrong. Because past medical history, what are the medications that has been taken and all those things has already been there in the medical history form. So what is new in nursing history? It is the problems. Either it can be not related to the problem which he is coming to the hospital. There might be several problems. There might be social problems. There might be psychological problems. There might be any physical disturbances, whether he is not gonna, that is not the reason why he came today for the hospital. There might be some things. So a nurse's history covers more than medical history, because nurse is gonna see the patient in a holistic way. Not only the physical aspect, but also the psychosocial, spiritual, as well as mental. In medical history, the doctor is always concerning or putting his main concern on the physical, difficulty what he is having now, and what was the history of this physical discomfort that he is presenting with now. So he is not concerning about how many members are there in their family, how you came to this place, whether it is from a public transport or whether it is from a trishaw or not. What is your occupation? It is a dusty place or not? Whether those kind of health concerns are not concerning by this medical history. Those things has to be done by a nurse. So a nurse's history is so in depth, because we are not focusing at the present problem. We are focusing at what has happened to this person to cause this problem. Because, you know, if we take this WHO definition of health, what we have is complete state of being physical, mental, social and spiritually wealthy. So, in nowadays, nursing, what you call these theories has been changed. Now what we are focusing more is in which aspect? Is it the physical? No. It's the mental and the social. Because psychosocial aspect, what we call as this psychological as well as this social aspect, is more higher and making more impact on our health. Sometimes we are physically stable, but mentally unstable. So altogether our self is unstable. There are so many people who are having physical disabilities but mentally stable. Those people are living or having a stable life in this world. Even though he is suffering from this bad cold or from even with amputated leg, he might have a very good self-esteem than us. If you are physically ill and if you are mentally strong, you are in a stable manner. Even though you are mentally unstable, even though you are physically stable or mentally unstable, your life is unstable. Imagine a time when you are working in the hospital which you came from the home with so much problems, family problems or something. Will you be able to do your work correctly? No. Everything is flushed out. Once you are entering to the ward, you might be pissed off by the work. And you see someone smiling, and when you came and you saw the roster and you have put three knives together, oh my God, your full mood is gone. And where all this pressure goes out? From the patient. I was not being given a duty leave to go to the, to go to my son's parents meeting. It was gone out through a cannula of a patient. You might give the IV. That is the way. All our pressure will be released in some way. If we are nurses, that is why all the other people who's dealing with us, but what we are telling is, don't ever mess with a nurse. Nurses are so dangerous, they might end up giving an AR embolism to you that you might die without even a diagnosis. 3cc syringe is enough from a hospital to kill a patient. That is why never mess with nurses. Nurses are so good they have this emotional and everything, but don't mess with them. They are so dangerous to deal. That is the way. Most of them are women. And so, it is more critical. So, never messed up with a nurse. You might not know how you are gonna die. Sometimes you might end up with a carotid massage and you may die. You have seen the carotid? When you press the carotid, two carotids together, of course your cerebral blood flow will stop and you might get, of course first you will have this faintishness, then you might die, you won't know. That is why you should not get messed with a nurse. Nurses are so dangerous, they know so many ways to kill the people with mercy. Not by their face, because they are so calm and quiet people in the world, but very dangerous inside. So that is why when we are mentally unstable, especially nurses, all our pressure is going through the patient's veins. That's what I'm telling. Always it goes through patient's veins, because we are always dealing with the veins. That is what we like most to see. It will go through your veins. Never mess with them. So in this, when you are taking a history, as the same way, not like doctors, because they won't stay with the patient for a longer period. Nurses are the one who is dealing with the patient for the 24 hours. We know what is their strengths, weaknesses, what are the allergies whatsoever. He might take it as the, what do you call in this medical history form, but he might not see the patient, the way that the patient is going to the toilet. Those things that doctor has never seen, those kind of things. Nurses are the one who is concerning about those things. Whether he is able to sleep in the bed or not. Is he isolated person or not in the ward? Whether he is talking with the patient who is next to him or not. It shows his behavior. Whether he is a cunning person or a very social person. Or an isolated behavior. Whether he is having any mental stress. It won't come through medical history form. Because it is not taking. It is not what the doctor wants. What the doctor wants is to cure the patient. Cure the current condition. Which he is suffering from. It might be a common cold. But he may have family problems that makes him more depressed than this common cold. That is why nurses' history is so different, because we are seeing the patient at a holistic way. We are going to see what is their problem, what are the causes to it, and what will be the bad effect in the future. That is why there are two nursing diagnoses, which are called as potential nursing diagnoses as well as actual ones. Actual ones explain what are the problems which the patient is having now. And what do you mean by the potential diagnosis? What can happen to this patient in the future? He might come up with a wound. Doctor might write for antibiotics to heal the wound. But what we are seeing is, it might get, there is a risk for infection. There is a risk for a very long hospital stay till the wound get healed. He might get anxiety related to the prolonged hospitalization. That is what we are ending up. That much far away we are thinking as nurses. Because doctors are seeing at a very particular point. At a very, very short time. Nurses' history are so different. Because we are seeing from positive end to negative end. There are so many things that we are going to find through our history form. And nursing history form depends on three things. It is according to the institutional policies. Sometimes we are not able to get all the details of the patient because of the privacy and confidentiality that has to be maintained of the patient. Those are institutional policies. Can you ask about, commercial sex worker comes as a patient in the ward. Can you ask about how many with how many men that you have slept? how many has been there for yesterday and day before yesterday. Those things cannot be us. It's due to the institutional policy, and that is privacy, of course, and it should be confidential.
And nursing models of the organization.
Talking about the nursing models, have you ever heard about nursing models? Just like cost analysis models. Nursing, not nursing models means not the one who is in the fashion show. Those are not nursing. Have you seen nursing models? I think few are there in Sri Lanka now. Nurses who are working as models. Few are there. You might know someone. There are so many people, not actually models, role models are there. Nursing models means there are so many nursing theorists in the world who has invented their own models to nursing. Models mean a model to give the care, how to arrange the care of the patient. There are so many models that has been invented by so many people. Who is the first inventor, or who has given the first model? Florence Nightingale. She has given a model of caring. How the nurse should behave. What are the do's and don'ts the nurse should practice in the clinical setting. So those things, how to clean the walls of the ward. She has written each and everything. That is a model. That is a concept. So what is the model? There are so many models, so many theories. After Florence Nightingale, Virginia Henderson, 14 needs. That's a model. She has invented a model called 14 needs, that when you are taking a history, you have to consider about those 14 needs of this page. Who else? Dorothy Oram. Dorothy Oram has invented the model called a self-care model. What she is telling is that the patient may be unable to do his self-care. So there are so many self-care components that has to be elimination, food, drink, air, water and everything. Those things have to be assessed of this patient. That is Dorothy Oram's self-care model. Who else? There are vast variety of nursing models. Sister Calista Roy, adaptation model. And Catherine Kolkaba, comfort theory. Who else? There are so much more. If you go downstairs and see in the nursing library, you might find nursing theories and practices book. A very large book. Where you can see more than
30-35 nursing
models and theories. Who has invented so much more things to the nursing career.
So, your nursing history form depends on which model that your organization is following.
It can be either Virginia Henderson 14 needs. You know about this hospital, Florence Nightingale Hospital, I mean the hospital that she has built up long time before. It is following the model of Virginia Henderson nursing concepts. But some hospitals might consider someone else model as their nursing model of the institution. So what is the model which is using in Sri Lanka? In Sri Lankan setup we have, what is the model? Currently Sri Lankan nursing, currently Sri Lankan history, what is the model that we are following from the very beginning? Nursing model. It is a combination of two models. But still, it's not using, it is only using in the, exams of NTS. That's it. Other than that, we are not having a proper nursing history model which is using in the hospital. We are using a combination of both. We'll discuss it. And our nursing history depends on the type of the patient. Because we can't use the same history for a dialysis patient or a medical surgical patient or in an ICU or an emergency patient. We can't use the same history form. It has to be LIFR.
So these are nursing models. There are nursing models as well as non-nursing models. A framework. We'll talk about a framework because this is the way that we gonna use our form. Imagine this is the patient care. Imagine this is a frame, right? This is a frame. There are so many ways to look at this. People can look at it from this side. Imagine these are aspects. These are social. These are physical. Mental. Spiritual. Here this side, self-care. Any whatsoever. There are so many ways that you can. If this is what we call as patient care, you can look at it in different angles depending on the model that you are using. Have you got that thing? Either your model can mostly focus on the mental aspect of the patient care, right? Either your model can mainly focus on the social aspect of the patient care. Either your model can focus on the self-care of this patient. Either it can be physical. This is mainly done by this doctors. They are mostly concerning about this aspect. Physical aspect of the patient. Right? So your nursing history depends on which angle you are looking at the patient here. It depends. So your nursing history form might be different from yours because you might think spiritual aspect is your main focus. But you might think what mental aspect is more higher. It depends because all our history forms can be different because of the angle what we are looking. But the angle what we are looking is called as a framework. If you look at this angle, you can see this patient here in a different way. When someone is looking at from this eye of the spiritual, this whole framework is somewhat different. That is why it says a framework is a way of looking at something. So each and every person's framework can be different. Each and every institution's framework can be different. Private hospitals are looking at the patient care as patient care plus business. That is their framework. Public health sector is looking at patient care as free health care. That is another framework. So there are so much more frameworks. Because imagine about the Sri Lanka, if you take, if your son or daughter is late to come from, late to come to home, maybe about 12 midnight, she is not there. But it is normal into the framework of America. But it is abnormal according to the framework of Sri Lanka. Because the way we are looking at it is so different. It is a very normal thing that you know you are not coming before midnight in America. No one is coming before the midnight. Everyone comes after the midnight. But it is like a huge war or explosion if your parents know that you are coming after 9:30 or 10. It is also a very huge burden or any big problem. So there are so many ways. That is what I want to explain is a framework is the way that you are looking at something in your angle. So there are so many nursing models and non-nursing models. Florence Nightingale's concepts are there. Dorothy Oram self-care. Henderson's need theory. 14 needs. Betty Newman's system model. This is Sister Calista Roy's adaptation. Hildegard Papale's nurse patient relationship theory, Catherine Kolkaba's comfort, Gordon's functional health patterns. There are so
which we are using, because it has some contribution to nursing also. There is a connection.
One of the best is what we are using as Maslow's hierarchy. Is Maslow a nurse? No. Maslow is not a nurse. He is a psychologist. So he has invented something called as Maslow's hierarchy, not to nursing. That is to the human needs in psycho, in psychology. So, but we are using it in our nursing setting. We have changed it a bit, which is according to the patient's needs. That is the word what we are using. Patient's needs. We are referring. But he has never told it as patient's need. What he has used is, that is Maslow's hierarchy of needs of each and every person. But when we are using it to the clinical setting, we are converting it to a patient needs.
So the model which is using in Sri Lanka is a combination of this and this. Body system model is basically using by whom?
Body system means you are going to get the data according to the body system. That is also a model. Who is using it mostly? Doctors. Have you seen that they are taking the data? GI, urinary, reproductive, respiratory, cardiovascular. That is the way they are taking the details. That is the model that we are using to our physical examination. In our nursing assessment, there are two parts, history taking and physical examination.
Body system is the way that we are using it in our
physical examination. That is the way we are doing, right? We will head to toe examination, but according to system wise. We will check the pulse, heart rate and everything in cardiovascular, respiratory and nervous. We are going to check the, what you call, the sensation and everything. Those things are there in the body system world.
In Sri Lanka, what we have is this Florence Nightingale's theory plus the Maslow's hierarchy. That we gotta check this airway, breathing, circulation as the physical needs. Then, of course, we gotta go for this. What comes the next? Security and safety. Of course, what we are doing as hand washing, everything.
That is for the safety of the patient. If we take all our
procedures and everything, there are interventions related to each and every step of the procedure. It goes with this Maslow's hierarchy and the combination of nursing concepts into it by Florence Nightingale. So it is a combination of both of those concepts, nursing and non-nursing.
You know, if you are using an individual nursing model only to the patient, yeah, it is less effective. You should combine
two nursing models and a non-nursing model together to become more effective. It is what we are doing at our exams. The model that we are using is more effective than using a single model of this. We can't use this Kolkaba's comfort theory. Why?
It only addresses the comfort, that is their framework.
What she has seen is only the comfort. What she is telling is the patient care is always providing the comfort to the patient by each and every component. Either it can be his self-care attitude or anything. Everything should have a comfortable level. That is what she said. But we can't use that kind of raw model to the nursing sector. So we have to combine a nursing model as well as a non-nursing model to give more effective patient care. These are Gordon's functional, it is on their book. Because these things also what we are using, because it is Malaysian book and Gordon's functional one, it has been there. I have put it here because papers are not coming here. Have you heard about this evaluation mode of this subject? This is nursing health assessment. For this, you're going to have an exam as well as a assignment. Exam, you will get 60 marks out of 100. For the
what you call assignment, you will get 40. So combining both, you will get 100 marks. So you have to put equal kind of weight for both of the assignment as well as for the exam. In exam you might write, but always put yourself into writing this assignment, because it's almost 40 marks and it is not very hard one. This is really easy. When you are writing something, we are not going to check for the plagiarism, of course, very, you know, in a hard way. Because, and we are sending them the hard copies of your assignment. So not to be scared. You have the chance to get internet articles, but don't write it 100% in the internet. At least you should put yourself, you should contribute. Other than that, it is useless getting a degree if you are copywriting everything from the internet. I mean, it means you are not suitable to get a degree if you are copywriting everything. Because we are not by-born English people. That is the most, prominent difficulty that each and every one of us are facing. We are not by-born English people. We are by-born Sinhala or Tamil speaking people. English is somewhat different. If you are concerning about English, and Sri Lanka is the only country which is measuring the intelligence level by the English. So if you are measuring the intelligence level, that means beggars in UK are more intelligent than us, because they are by-born talking English. It is a very stupid kind of concept which is using in Sri Lanka. ඉංග්‍රීසි කියන්නේ සුද්දගේ භාෂාව. ඒක අපිට අදාළ දෙයක් නෙමෙයි. හොඳට ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන්න පුළුවන් කියන එකෙන් මිනිස්සයාගේ බුද්ධිය මනින්න බෑ. බුද්ධිය කියන්නේ somewhat so different. ඔයාගේ බුද්ධිය මනින්න බෑ වෙන කිසිම දෙයකින්. ඔයා පෙන්නන ඔයාගේ හැකියාවයි දක්ෂතාවයෙන් ගැනෙන්නේ ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන එක. එහෙනම් ඉතින් අර හිඟන්නටත් ඉතින් ඉංග්‍රීසි කතා කරන්න පුළුවන් නිසා ඒ වුණොත් අපිට වඩා බුද්ධිමත් වෙන්න ඕනේ. එහෙම නෑනේ. ඒක නිසා තමයි. එකම දේ මේ assignment එකක් ලියද්දි copy paste කරන්න එපා කියලා මම කියන්නේ. Copying is an art. එකම දේ copy paste කරන එක උනත් කලාවක්. ගෙඩි පිටින් copy paste කරන්න එපා. මේවා mark කරද්දි අහු වෙනවා ලස්සරට. ඇයි? Wikipedia එකෙන් ගන්නවා. එයාට අමතකයි ඒකේ තිබ්බ සමහර වචන අයින් කරන්න. About table shows කියලා දානවා. About table එකක් නෑ. Below table shows කියනවා. Below table එකකුත් නෑ. එතකොට අපි දන්නවා ඉතුරු උඩ ඔක්කොම ටික copy paste කරලා ගෙඩිය පිටින් දාලා කිව්. අනිත් එක තමයි මේවා අයින් කරන්න අමතක වෙන්නේ. මෙහෙම. Wikipedia එකේ අකුරු එන්නේ එක font එක. සාමාන්‍යයෙන් assignment එක ලියන font එක මොකද්ද? Times New Roman size 12. එක එක size වලට assignment ලියන්න එපා. Standard එක size 12. අනිත් එක තමයි සබ් ටොපික්ස් කුකුල් සයිස් 14 16 කරන්නේ නැහැ. ඔක්කොම 12. මුළු පොතේ කොහෙවත් 14 න් ඉහා මේ 12 න් ඉහා ඒව නැහැ. සබ් ටොපික්ස් වලට හරි ටොපික්ස් වලට හරි කරන එකම දේ. ඒක බෝල්ඩ් කරන එක විතරයි. අනිත් එක ටයිම්ස් නිව් රෝමන් නෙමෙයි කියලා අපිට හොඳට තේරෙන්නේ ඕම් මේව ටයිම්ස් නිව් රෝමන් වලින් කියනවා. ඊට පස්සේ මේ ටික ඔන්න කැලිබ්‍රි පොඩියක්. ඊට පස්සේ ආයෙ යනවා තව එකක්. ඔන්න ආයෙත්. එතකොට තේරෙනවා ආටිකල් පහකින් හයකේ හොඳට කොපි පේස්ට් කරලා තියෙනවා. ඊළඟට Wikipedia එකෙන් ගත්තා කියලා හොඳට පේනවා මෙන්න මෙහෙම තියෙනවා පොඩි ඉන්ඩෙක්. එහෙම 1 2 එහෙම දාලා තියෙන්නේ. ඒ 1 2 දාලා තියෙන රෙෆරන්සස් වලටනේ. එහෙම මෙහෙම දාලා තියෙනවා. මේක පිටින්ම ඕකත් අරගෙන දැන් අපි දන්නවා මේව කොහෙවත් රෙෆරන්සස් දාලා නැහැ. මේ විදිහට අපේ රෙෆරන්සස් යන්නේ. මේක ස්ටයිල් එක. මේ රෙෆරන්සින් යන්නේ එක ස්ටයිල් එක. එහෙම 1 2 දාලා යනවා. ඒවා අයින් කරන්න අමතක කර. එහෙම කරන්න එපා. Copying is an art. Copy කිරීම කලාවක්. හරියට කලාව ප්‍රගුණ කරන්න. මේ කාලේ කලාව ප්‍රගුණ කරාම පස්සේ කාලයක් වෙද්දී ඔයගලගේ ෆයිනල් ඉය වෙද්දී උදේ අපි 8ට assignment එකක් දීලා කිව්වොත් 12ට submit කරන්න කියලා. කට්ටිය 12ට assignment පටපට ගාලා විසික් කරනවා. ඒ තරම් කලාව ප්‍රගුණ කරපු මිනිස්. That is, ඒවට තියෙන්නේ මොනවාද? ක්‍රම සහ විදි තිබුණේ නැහැ. විදි තිබුණේ පරණ කාලේ. දැන් තියෙන්නේ ක්‍රම සහ උපක්‍රම. ක්‍රම සහ උපක්‍රම පාවිච්චි කරලා අවුරුදු දෙකයි මාස හතරෙන් මොකද ඩිග්‍රිය ගොඩ දාගන්න ඕනේ. ඒක නිසා කරද්දි හැබැයි තමන්ගේ කන්ට්‍රිබියුෂන් එකක් නැතුව ටොපික් එක මොකක්ද කියලා දන්නේ නැතුව අඳුරේ අතපත ගාලා නම් assignment ලියන්න බෑ. හරි විදිහට ලියනවා නම් assignment එකක් ලියන්න පැය 3ක් හොඳටම ඇති. වචන 2500යි ලියන්න තියෙන්නේ. වචන 2500 හසුරවන විදිහ ඔයාලට assignment discussion එකක් තියෙනවනේ ආයේනේ. කරේ නෑනේ. assignment discussion එකේදී කියලා දෙන්නම් කොහොමද කියලා. කවදද deadline තියෙන්නේ? 28 මේ. ඔයාලගේ ඊළඟ class එක තියෙන්නේ කවදද? 28 April. 28th class එකේ අපි discuss කරමු assignment එක ලියන්නේ කොහොමද කියලා. assignment එක module දාලා තියෙනවා. එදාට එද්දි බලාගෙන ඉන්න. assignment එක හරි ලේසි මං චුට්ටක් කියන්නම්. assignment is all about nurse. අපි prioritize කරනවනේ nursing වල. patients need prioritize කරන්නේ. ඒකට Maslow's hierarchy එක වැදගත් වෙන්නේ කොහොමද කියලායි ලියන්න ඕනේ. ඒක chapter wise ලියන්න තියෙනවා. සාමාන්‍යයෙන් assignment එකක chapter 5යි reference උත් එක්ක. මං එදාට කියලා දෙන්නම් assignment එකේ මොන මොන කොටස් වලට කොච්චර කොළද ලියන්න ඕනේ. introduction එකට හැලී ලිව්වට වැඩක් නැහැ. ලකුණු 4යි දෙන්නේ එක පිටුවයි ලියන්න ඕනේ. chapter 2 වලට ලකුණු 6ක් දෙනවා. එහෙනම් පිටු 2ක් 2මාරක් ලියන්න ඕනේ. chapter 3 එකට ලකුණු 10ක් දෙනවා. එතකොට අඩුම තරමින් පිටු 3ක් 3මාරක්වත් ලියන්න ඕනේ. chapter 4 එක තමයි ලොකුම. ඒකට ලකුණු 12ක් දෙනවා. chapter 4 ලකුණු 12 ගන්න අඩුම තරමින් පිටු 5ක්වත් ලියලා තියෙන්න ඕනේ. ඒ පිටු 5ක් ලියන එකට බය වෙන්න එපා. මේ හැම රූප නැතුව මම කියන්නේ. අනිත් එක තමයි කළුයි සුදුයි ලියාගෙන යන්න එපා. අතර මගට ටිකක් පිළිවෙල වෙන්න රූපයක් දාන්න. මැස්ලෝ හයිරාකිය කියන ත්‍රිකෝණයේ හැම තියෙන පිරමීඩ එක ඒකේ හැම රූපයක් දාන්න. එතකොට ලස්සනයි. ඊට පස්සේ කන්ක්ලූෂන් එක පිටු භාගයයි. ඒකට ලකුණු 4යි. ඔයා කොච්චර ලිව්වත් වැඩක් නැහැ. ඔයාට හම්බෙන්නේ ලකුණු 4යි. හැම වෙලාවෙම ලකුණු ගැන සලකලා බලලා ලියන්න ඕන කොළ ගාන තීරණය කරන්න. කන්ටෙන්ට් එක මොකද්ද කියලා තීරණය කරන්නේ ලකුණු ගාන හැම වෙලාවෙම බලන්න. ලකුණු ගාන මත තමයි depend වෙන්නේ. introduction එහෙම සමහරක් අය ලියනවා පිටු 3 4 වැඩක් නැහැ. ලකුණු 4යි. අන්තිම වෙන්නේ ඔයා හති වැටිලා ඉවරයි. එතකොට chapter 4 ලකුණු 12 ගන්න එකට පිටු 1.2යි. ඒ වෙද්දී වැඩක් නැහැ. ඒක ටාගට් කරන්න. conclusion එක කියන්නේ සාරාංශ. ඒක පිටු භාගයයි. අන්තිමට references දාන්න references වලට ලකුණු 4යි. ඉතින් ඔය ලකුණු 40 ගන්න බැරි නෑ. 40න් 35ක් 36ක් 37ක් 38ක් කියන්නේ ගන්න පුළුවන්ම ගන්න. references ඔයාලා අතින් දාන්නේ නෑනේ. references දාන්නේ අර ඔගොල්ලෝ දන්නව නේද references දාන්න විදිහ ඉන්ටර්නෙට් එකේ YouTube video එකක හරි බලන්න. references දාන්න හරි ලේසි. මොකද word document එකේ references කියලා tab එකක් තියෙනේ. ඒ tab එකට ගිහිල්ලා පොතක්ද journal article එකක්ද කියලා විස්තර ටික දාන්න විතරයි ඕනේ. automatically කොලේ අන්තිම පිටුවට ගිහිල්ලා search කරාම select කරලා දැම්මම ඔක්කොම references ටික A to Z APA format එකෙන් වැටෙනවා. ඔයා අමුතුවෙන් ආයෙ කමාවක් දාලා තිතක් දාලා ස්පේස් එකක් තිය references ලියන්නේ නැහැ. ආන් ඒක. අපේ කට්ටිය තව references දාන හොඳ ක්‍රමයකට ඒක අහුවෙන්නේ. දැන් research article එකේ තියෙන references. ඒ මිනිස්සයා ලියලා තියෙන්නේ references. ඒව දානවා අපේ අය. ඒකේ සමහරක් ඒව හදිසියෙන් හරි ගිහිල්ලා බලුවම ඒව ගන්න බෑ. ඒ article කියවන්න ඩොලර් 5ක් 10ක් 15ක් වියදම් කරන්න ඕනේ. ඒ කියන්නේ හිතා ගන්නකෝ ලකුණු 40 රිසර්ච් එකක් ගන්න මේ ළමයා රුපියල් 1500ක් වියදම් කරලා ආටිකල් එකක් ඉන්ටර්නෙට් එකෙන් පර්චේස් කරලා කියවලා කියලා තමයි අපිට එන්නේ හැංගීම. ඒත් එහෙම නැහැ. ඒ කරලා තියෙන්නේ අර තිබ්බ ආටිකල් එකක අන්තිම ඒ තිබ්බේ ඒ වැඩේ කරන්න එපා. ඒක හරි නැහැ. ඔයාලා ඔයාලගේ රිසර්ච් ආටිකල් ඔයාලා හොයන දාන්න ඒව දාන්න රෙෆරන්සස් ඔය ඕන තරම් ආටිකල් තියෙනවා ඉන්ටර්නෙට් එකේ විකීපීඩියා Google ගිහලා සර්ච් කරා ගන්න නැති තරමට තියෙනවා කොහොමද මැස්ලෝස් හයිරාකි නර්සින් වලට කනෙක්ට් වෙන්නේ කියලා මැස්ලෝ කියන්නේ නර්ස් කෙනෙක් නෙවෙයි මැස්ලෝගේ හයිරාකි එක නර්සින් වලට ගහපු එකකුත් නෙවෙයි අපි ලියන්න ඕනේ අපේ ප්‍රයෝරිටයිස් කරන්න අපි නර්සින් වල හැම වෙලාවෙම අපි මිනිස්සුගේ අවශ්‍යතා අනුපිළිවෙලට හදනවනේ ඒක මැස්ලෝගේ හයිරාකි එක හරහා කරන්නේ කොහොමද මැස්ලෝගේ ඒකට නර්සින් වලට තියෙන මේ හයිරාකි එකේ නර්සින් වලට තියෙන මේ බලපෑ ඒක තමයි ලියන්න ඕනේ ඒක ලොකු දෙයක් නෙවෙයි කල්පනා කරලා බැලුවොත් ඔයිට වඩා දේවල් ඒකේ ලියන්න පුළුවන් මෙන්න මේක එක්සෑම් පේපර් එකට ලිස්ට් කරන්න කියලා අහලා තිබ්බා. ඒකයි මම මේ සයිට් එක දාන්න හේතුව. දැන් මෙතන මේ ඕන තරම් දේවල් තියෙනවනේ වර්ජිනියා හෙන්ඩර්සන් ගේ 14 නම් අපේ NTS පේපර් වල ඇහුවා. Can you remember Virginia Henderson 48 days? Eat well, drink well, rest and sleep. Those things has been done. So මෙන්න මේක පාඩම් කරගන්න බොහෝ දුරට it may come to write as අර pointing of list out the Gordon's functional health pattern. Gordon කියලා කියන්නේ නර්ස් කෙනෙක්. He has made this Gordon functional health pattern theory. You may come up that. Revision කරනවා ඔයාලට. Class ආවෙ නැත්නම් revision වලට එන්න අමතක නම් කරන්න එපා. Revision එක දවසට past papers ඔක්කොම discuss කරනවා. Past papers are usually it is coming with the question bank. So sometimes the same question might get repeated and same structure is repeating every year same structure not the same question but same structure කොච්චරද කියනවනම් ඔයාලගේ nursing health assessment exam එක ගොඩක් ලේසි subjective data objective data ලියන්න දෙනවා ඒකත් ඡේදයක් දීලා case scenario එකක් දීලා patient presented with cough cold he said on admission bp මෙහෙම දාලිවල ඊළඟට අහනවා subjective data මොනවාද cough patient complaint කරපුවා ලියනවා objective data උඩම තියෙනවා pulse bp respiration temperature ඔක්කොම ටික එතන තියෙනවා ඒ ටික ලියන්න ඕන ආන් ඒ වගේ පොඩි පොඩි ප්‍රශ්න තියෙනවා බය වෙන්න එපා මේ subject එක this is a very easy one not a very hard subject this is almost there in your book
I think 25th page
Everything is there.
Shall we get a small break or?
On in there, Nanda?
No.
Okay.
If anyone wants to go to the washroom and come, you might go and come, right? Talking about this is in-depth assessment. In-depth assessments are needed in special situations.
One is wellness assessment. Of course, we are not doing these. This is all, I mean, these are all from these Malaysian books in Malaysia. This might have practice. This is wellness assessment, which you can assess the wellness, the nutritional status, resting pattern, sleeping pattern, behavioral pattern of the clients. It can be not limited to the patients in the hospital. It can be either anyone in this community. Anyone, any person which you are meeting, you can do wellness assessment. These are special kind of assessment. And the other one is community assessment. In the community setup, in your area, when you are doing community nursing, this kind of assessment can be done. All of you have been there for the community visits, right? In NTS, of course. Can you remember the form that we have filled in the MOH and everywhere? When we are going to a home, assessment, that is community assessment. We will ask each and every question from the parents, guardians and everything about the children, and as well as what is their age, what are the disease that they are suffering from, what are their behaviors, everything, whether they have this development milestones has been achieved or not. Those kind of things are community assessment, which we are using in the community setup. So there are different kind of assessment methods. That is what I want to tell, in-depth assessment, which we are doing. Is it the same or more broader than our normal nursing history? This is broader. Why? Because we are seeing this patient without any disease. When the patient is coming to the hospital, he is coming there with a disease or any sickness. But these things are not basically due to a sickness. These things, what we are doing is to assess the lifestyle of the patient. This is, of course, health promotion. This is actually health promotion. We are doing this promotion and preventive care in the community as well as to any people on this earth. We can do these kind of assessment. These are in-depth assessment which are more broader than our normal nursing assessment which we are practicing at the ward setup. Okay. We'll start about this. These are the principles of effective documentation. When we are documenting anything, there should be what? There should be an effective way. Before talking about this, I'll show a small video clip of documentation errors, right?
The quotes on the following slides were obtained from this website. They represent doctors' notes on their patients. They are actual notes that have not been edited.
It is a small funny video.
Patient has chest pain if she lies on her left side for over a year. On the second day, the knee was better, and on the third day, it disappeared completely. Both breasts are equal and reactive to light and accommodation. I saw your patient today who is still under our car for physical therapy. Since she can't get pregnant with her husband, I thought you might like to work her up. Between you and me, we ought to be able to get this lady pregnant. Rectal exam revealed a normal size thyroid. She has had no rigors or shaking chills, but her husband states she was very hot in bed last night. The patient has been depressed ever since she began seeing me in 1993. Patient has two teenage children, but no other abnormalities. The lab test indicated abnormal liver function. She stated that she had been constipated for most of her life, until she got a divorce. The patient is tearful and crying constantly. She also appears to be depressed. Discharge status, alive but without permission. Healthy appearing, decrepit 69-year-old male, mentally alert but forgetful. The patient refused an autopsy. The patient has no past history of suicides. Patient has left his white blood cells at another hospital. Patient's past medical history has been remarkably insignificant, with only a 40-pound weight gain in the past 3 days. While in the ER, she was examined, x-rated, and sent home. Skin somewhat pale, but present. The skin was moist and dry. Occasional, constant, infrequent headaches. Patient had waffles for breakfast and anorexia for lunch. She is numb from her toes down. Patient was alert and unresponsive. The patient was to have a bowel resection. However, he took a job as a stockbroker instead. Thank you.
Those are the documentation errors. Are rectal examination making thyroid, normal size thyroid එකක් තිබ්බ වගේ තමයි. Because once you are writing, you may have something else in your head and it will be there. So in patient's record, you can't erase, scratch, tipex, or correct it again and again. Because in legal documents, you can't do those things. You know about legal documents when you are writing an affidavit or anything? Or imagine in your house what you call for the loans and everything. Can you rewrite it? Can you tipex those banking addresses and everything? No. That is the same way which you have to consider about this medical records, these nursing records. These are true things which has given by these people, medical doctors, nurses, everyone. Those documentation errors. So we'll move on to this. This is about the principles of effective documentation. What are the principles? Main principles of effective documentation means these principles has to be there in your document. Right? These principle has to be there. One, assessment. Nursing assessment has to be there in the BHT as a document. Nursing diagnosis has to be there. Maybe shift by shift or daily nursing diagnosis should be there. Planning and outcomes of the identification. The planning, basically what is this all about? What is this all six? That means nursing records should be there in the BHT to make it a complete one. These are the main principles that should that a nurse should document. And talking the last one, it is revisions of plan care. Because at the admission, you might write the nursing care plan. Can you continue it until the discharge? Can you continue the same plan? No. It should be revised daily or shift wise. Because patient's condition may change minute by minute. So you can't apply the same care plan to the patient until the discharge. Your patient care plan will be revised. Maybe it can be daily or weekly or whatsoever according to the time which the patient is living in the hospital. So these are the main principles. elements of nursing process needed to be made evident in documentation. So all these six elements should be written in the nursing records. You might write each and everything, but evaluation sometimes you forget. Evaluation. After doing the procedure, you have planned and you have implemented, you forgot to evaluate it with the previous condition and what is the current condition. You have to evaluate. Evaluation should not be missed. Each and every principle has to be there. And these are the effective documentation elements. When you are documenting, what is the first thing that you have to do? Use a common vocabulary. That means you can't write your own things. There is a common vocabulary. What is the language that we are writing the nurse's notes? It's English. When you are writing it in English, you can't write it like an essay type. There are specific kind of language that we are using. You can't write it in Sinhala. You can't write it in Tamil. You can't write it in any other language. And when you are writing, can you use all the English words or specific kind of nursing or scientific words? Specific words. You can't write fever. That is a medical term. You have to write hypothermia. As the same way, you can't write each and everything in there in your own words. There are specific kind of vocabulary which is going on. That is why even doctors have in this medical terminology, those medical words, there are so much more nursing words. You can't say that he is skinny and he is so thin. You can't something like that. You can say nutritional status. You can talk about the nutritional status of the patient or the appearance of the patient which is related with this nutritional status. He looks pale. Pale is something that you can write. Pallor, that is a medical term. Those kind of medical terminology is there in practice. You can't write each and everything. There are so many things that you can, when the patient is complaining, sometimes the patient might say, can you write it like that? Well, lightning type of headache. Can you explain it in the same way? Current is passing from the loin to groin pain. Current is passing from the back of the patient till the right leg. Knee. You can't write. So use a common vocabulary and write legibly and neatly. Legibly means which is easy to read. It should be neat and tidy and legibly. Handwriting should be perfect. Something that others can read and take any information from the notes that you have written. So it should be neat and tidy. And the other one is use only authorized abbreviations. You can't write each and abbreviation by your anything like this. You can't write these. What is this?
For all patients, Valapaya Godapaya. No need to get hurry for the treatments.
It's almost WPGP. You can't write those things. It is BDO, TDSO, SOS, Vesper, Mane, Nocte. Those things are of course medical abbreviation. Other than that, you can't write your own things. But this thing, of course, we are writing, right?
This is what you are not. This cannot be. Patient is sometimes we are writing it like that way.
This is not the standard, but with this almost there. We are writing that. Patient. If you see the medical terms, that is most horrible one. And the other one is we can't write brand names. That is prohibited. There are so many research that has been done in Sri Lanka to find about doctors, medical doctors' awareness, knowledge practice attitude on generic nomenclature and branded nomenclature. Their knowledge practice and attitudes are not in a very good level. They have a very good knowledge, but their practice and attitudes to write, that I have to write because someone might get confused, that is not there. That is why most of the medication errors has been there. Because their handwriting is somewhat aliens ones, not from a normal language. So you can't write, when you are documenting, you can't use unauthorized, your own abbreviations. There should be standardized ones. And the other one is employee fluctual and time sequenced organizations one. That means you have to have an organization. You can't write the 2 o'clock note at 4 o'clock. Or at the time of 7 o'clock when you are handing over, you can't write your 2 o'clock giving over, taking over notes on that time. Once you are taking the patient to you, you have to write a small note that I have taken the patient. In private sector hospital, we have this. We are writing this handing over. Handed over the patient to this one that she is writing and signing. And what we are going is, we have taken over the patient from the morning staff or from the evening staff, nursing staff. At the moment, the vitals were checked and recorded. These are those. And patient to be seen by the VP, patient to be seen by the ward MO, those things has to be written in each and every document. In the government sector, we have this handing over, giving over book. That is the one what we have to write. That is not a standard one. That is according to the institutional policies, we are having that kind of book. But those things has to be written on the BHT. BHT is the legal document, not the handing over, giving over book. Sometimes it might be, things may be wrong in that. So, whenever you are writing, it should be employee fluctual. You have to take the responsibility for the things that you are writing. You can't change it again. And when you are writing the time of each and every thing, you have to use not AM, PM, it should be on the 24-hour basis, not in the 12-hour. And documents accurately and completely excluding any errors. You have to exclude all the errors. You have to go through all the records that you have written and finalize it. Finally, when you are giving over it to another nurse. Before that, you have to minimize all the errors what you have made. Because once you go home and you can't, give a call and tell, no, it is like this, that it has to be like this. No, you can't do. That is why. And finally, we're going to end up this doing all these things. These are the methods of documentation. This might come for the exam as, what are the methods of documentation in nursing? This is the most popular one we will go one by one. We will first discuss all these. One is narrative charting. Narrative means vistaratmakava, with all the details. We are going to explain with all the details. That is narrative charting. The other one is source-oriented charting. The other one is problem-oriented. We will always consider about a problem and we will write a description. Pie charting and part charting. Focus charting, charting by exception, computerized documentation, critical pathways. All these kind of documents are available in Sri Lanka. Even though it's in private public, it's available. I'll give you examples for each and every document. We are writing, we are documenting in each and every way. But what is the most famous way? Narrate. Patient was taken over, like that, patient's name is like that, on admission complaint. Same thing that we are writing, writing an essay, that is narrative. We are describing each and everything. We'll go each and every point. That is narrative charting. This is the traditional method of nursing documentation. Takes the form of a story written in paragraphs. That is the way we are writing. Narrative charting. When the patient is admitted, when someone asks when we are taking the patient, the patient got bad in the ward, so we are putting them into the ICU. How are you going to give the description? It's just like a paragraph. On admission, these were the complaints, vitals were measured, these investigations done, these were the medication, these were the treatment, and finally handing over the patient to the ICU staff. So that is narrative charting. That is the most common type of documentation that we are using in the ward setup. Then we have this. This is source-oriented charting, which we have separate records for separate healthcare personnel. Do we have that thing? Physiotherapist, physiotherapy record. Occupational therapist, another page different, which is always allowing the occupational therapist to write. VP's records are different, MO's records are different, nurse's notes are different. Are we having separate records like that? Source, that is source oriented. The source means the person who's oriented to write on that record. You can't write on VP's booklet or in that chart or whatsoever the paper. You have your separate papers to write. Do we have that kind of thing? I think in ICUs we have this, pink color pages for nurses' notes. And VPs or the medical officers things are different. That thing of course we are, writing. But we don't have this, do we have these separate notes for the, when physiotherapy comes, when he's giving this chest physiotherapy and all, he's not writing in a separate paper, right? Sometimes writing.
Source-oriented charting.
Anyway, in Sri Lanka, this is practicing, right? When the radiologist comes, he might write in some other. That is source-oriented charting. But in government sector, we don't have. We have the same BHT, whether the VP is writing, MO is writing, we are writing in the same thing. All the infusions and everything, 1 out of 5 pint is progressing or something, we are writing on that, right? In red pen, even the RBS also measured and written on the same BHT. We don't have this separate. We have. We have RBS and insulin medication, no? Something in ICUs, in ICU, in our, government sector, in ICU setup is so different from the ward setup. We have separate, we have this long, very large observation sheet. This is problem-oriented charting. This is, of course, the nursing care plan. This is the nursing care plan.
SOAP.
In exams, they have asked, what is SOAP and SOPIA chart? What is this? S, subjective, objective. It is included in the assessment. And what else? P, plan. Then what is I and E? What is I? E, what is R? Finish. So, problem-oriented charting is, what is the document? Nursing care plan. That is what we are having. So that is the example for SOPIA charting. Problem-oriented charting, that is the document. They might ask this. This always focuses on patient's problem. This is written by nurse. What is this? This will be uploaded today evening. After 5 minutes. Within 5 minutes it will be uploaded. You can go through. This is pie charting and part charting. Sometimes we are not writing full nursing care plan. What is problem intervention evaluation? Can you remember? It is also kind of narrative. When we have this stat medication and everything, sometimes what we are writing is patient complaint of nausea. Then inform MO. What else? What is the intervention? Stat dose of oral domperidone 10 milligram given. Stat dose given. That is, of course, what we called as this PIE charting, pie charting. Pie charting are there whenever, when the problem arises, we can't write this whole concept of nursing care plan. What we are writing is this. This is, of course, what we are using in the emergency cases. When emergency comes, this is kind of chart which we are doing. And this is, of course, part charting is also the same way. Problems come, then we'll do some actions, then we'll write the, what do you call this, response also. After this, after the evaluation, what do you mean by the evaluation? Of course, this thing has given, he has reduced the nauseated feeling. And what is the response here? It is also the same. The, both are same, what is difference here? Here we have this health education part, which is of course using, are we using this pie and part? Of course pie charts using, sometimes most of the time we are using this pie also. This teaching, are we having this teaching also? Whenever we have a problem, we will give domperidone and we will evaluate whether he has reduced the nauseated feeling or not. Are we doing this teaching part and writing it? Not that much, right? Because in this teaching means domperidone is antiemetic that we have given this to relieve this, and you might got the action within 20 minutes. That is a peak action hour. So you have reduced this. That is the teaching part. So each and every procedure we are not doing this. Especially pie charting comes, but part charting is rare. Part teaching session won't come, but in insulin, when we are administrating insulin before the meal, SC insulin, it is there. Teaching, after giving that, we are going to give at least small something, at least we are telling, now you can have the lunch. That is also kind of, a small advice that I have given insulin to you, so you are here. You might have a chance to get hypoglycemic, so it is the time to have your meal. When you are when we are administrating insulin or something like that, so here comes the part charting. Pie and part charting is available. It is practicing. This is focus charting. Focus charting is DAR. We'll write
on our BSC or something, we'll write the word D, then we will write data. D means data, A, action, R, response. We'll chart it by putting these three letters. D, data, we won't write it narratively. Data, what is data? Imagine a vomited case, nausea. What is the data? Patient complaints of vomiting. It is the same thing repeating, but we are using these three letters to write it separately. That one. A, inform MO, oral 10 milligram domperidone, ordered stat dose. R, response. Administered, this one we can say stat dose administered. Response. After 20 minutes, you have to measure the time and everything. After 20 minutes, nauseated feeling reduced. But don't forget, this is different from the pie chart, because in here we have to write DA. AR. That is a separate kind of record. It is written like this. Date and time.
Method, that is focus charting, a documentation method that uses a column format. It is a column format. Can you see? It is like Excel sheets, column formats. What we are writing is DAR. Here what we are talking is charting by exception. This is charting by exception means we won't write the normal values. We are only writing the deviations from the normal. We are not going to tell no fever, patient is afebrile, nothing. We only write or document what are the deviations from the normal. That means in QHD if every 4 hours early we will measure the temperature and note it down. It is something different. But if you are writing it like this way, in a charting by exception, you will measure the temperature but you won't write. Why? You are only writing what is abnormal. If the temperature is normal, you won't document it. Now, documentation might go really large if you are documenting each and everything which is normal. Sometimes, can you remember what we are doing here is, when we are taking the investigations, can you remember we are putting a flow sheet of investigation to measure the abnormal things. Is it practicing in other ward setup also? A sheet to write the abnormal values. We won't write the normal HB or WBC or whatsoever. If the CRP in the morning is abnormal, we will write it there. CRP taken at 4 a.m. 23rd of April 2017, what is the value? You might write it there. But if it's normal, if it is in the range, you might not write it. It is charting by exception. Give me an example that the time when you are writing exceptions only. Only the exceptions. You won't write the normal values. When we are doing this quick head-to-toe examination for an in the admission, we won't write all the normal things. We will write what is abnormal with the patient. Because a quick head-to-toe assessment cannot be, you can't write each and every aspect of the patient. No scar marks. If the scar marks are not present, no need to write no scar marks. If the scar mark is present, it is up to you to write scar mark present. Striae plus. Those things. Can you remember this abdominal examination in maternity? Flat umbilicus plus. Striae gravidarum plus. If it's not there, we won't write. Flat umbilicus not plus. Or it is minus. We won't write something like that. We will write what is there. Those are what we call as charting by exceptions. We will write the exception from the normal. This is computerized documents. Are we using it in the government healthcare sector? We have this admission system and we have this ICU bed. National intensive care. What do you call that? Surveillance system. We have that. To check the ICU beds and everything. Do we have that? NICS, yeah. National Intensive Care Surveillance, right? NICS Surveillance. So you will log in and you can find whether, if you are in Kurunagala, you can find whether ICU beds are available in the, when you call NHSL or not. So NHSL should update their ICU beds vacant or occupied in the system. So that is up to the nurse to put it, because nurse will be allocated according to the time shift for each and every bed. So if your bed is occupied, it is up to you to put it occupied. So if it's vacant, it is up to you to vacant it. That kind of systems are there. So those are computerized documents. There are so much more advantages of having computerized documentation. Why? Main is, we don't have to keep a very large space for the documentation storages like we are having in our hospitals. We can build another ward in that place rather than keeping a very large space to keep all the records. Everything can be added to a small memory chip. That's why it says computerized documentation in nursing is very easy. Why? It will minimize the time for the documentation. Because in foreign countries, even the nursing care plan is computer generated one. What you have to do is, here all the nursing diagnoses are there. None of the diagnoses are standard diagnoses. So it's up to you to touch and select what are the diagnoses which is related to the patient. It is on your touch. Okay, you have selected 5 diagnoses. Then for each diagnose, all kind of interventions might come. That is an ease, because imagine hypothermia. You want to reduce the fever. What are the interventions that you are having? What? Antipyretics. Administer antipyretics. What else? Tablets. What else? Ventilation. What else? Prepare the environment in a comfortable way. What else? Reduce overclothing. Imagine how many interventions that might come to you at the moment. But if you know about this cold facts and hot facts, you know about it. But if it won't come to you at the moment, it won't be written as an intervention. But if you go there and search it there, if it comes through the system, you know, there are things that I can do rather than giving an antibiotic. If you are using this computer system, your knowledge is getting refreshed every day. When hypothermia comes, you know more than 15 interventions are there. Sometimes even cold therapy is more effective than giving an antibiotic. Cooling therapy. That is also an intervention. You might not know that. I mean, if it's in the practical setting, cooling therapy is not here in Sri Lanka. If cooling therapy was here, it might come. So you won't end up giving such small antipyretic to the patient. Right? It is, of course, pharmacological management. Non-pharmacological managements are more effective sometimes rather than giving antibiotics. So that is why it will update our knowledge. It will go more interventions than you know, right? So it will give more interventions. And for each and every intervention, you know how to do it and what is the reason behind doing this. It shows through the internet or this system. So finally, it will come through the printer, your printed document of nursing care plan. You have touched and selected the diagnosis, it was there. You have touched and selected interventions for each and every diagnosis, it is there. What you have to do is, now, what? Implement the things that you have planned. The interventions that you have planned. So finally the outcome you can write it down. That is computer, that is an advantage of computerized documents, because your time will be, because when you are writing something, time consuming too much. But when it comes to the computerized system, everything is on your fingertips. So you have more time for the patient care rather than writing on the BHT. And it is clear when your handwriting might get different with the time and with the allocated time, or if you are having less time, of course it will be, you know, something that not eligible, not legible to others to read. So if it's computerized document, it is clear, accurate, because you are the one who is responsible, so you have this conscious level to select what are the diagnoses, what are the interventions and everything. And it is easy for the statistical analysis. You don't have to go to the record room and find it with dust, all the files and everything. Everything is there. Patients' records are, everything is computerized. So you can take statistical details easily. So, and it will enhance implementing the nursing process, because computer gives more intervention than in your head. That is why it is easy. And it is enhancing decision making. Sometimes you have only 5 interventions in your head, but the computer has given you more interventions, which you will decide what to be the best intervention for the care of the specific patient. And it is a multidisciplinary networking, which all the healthcare providers can be taken part in the care of the patient. Critical pathway, this is also something, a documentation which is there, which is usually, can have you, I mean, you might have seen, there are pathways like this, guidelines, which is on the walls. Febrile, it comes, what to do, then what to do, then what is the thing that has to be done, something like this. These are flow charts, those are critical pathways. If fits present, yes, then what is the thing has to do? If fits are not present, what are the things has to be done? Those are the things. Those are clinical guidelines. Those are called as critical pathways. Is this, common for all the patients? No. This has been made for specific kind of cases or situations. How to act? Because at that time you might not have the knowledge regarding the disease, what to do at the moment. That is why you should have these kind of charts or documents in your BHT. Okay. You know what to do next. That is rectal diazepam, how much? How many milligrams to administer where? To the patient. Whether the fits are there or not. If the fits are there, the chart goes in this way. If the fits are not there, then the chart goes on this way. That is what we called as the clinical guidelines or the critical pathways. These critical pathways are comprehensive standard plan like that for the care of the specific cases or situation. Just like the APGA in the labor room, if the APGA score is this, then you have to do these things. If the APGA score is in the moderate level, these are the things. If it's in the higher level or the normal level, nothing has to be done. Patient or the baby is in the normal condition. So that is another critical pathway. Critical pathways are there. Right? So that is also a document which should not be pasted on the wall, which should be added to the BHT of each and every specific case. So you might have time to write it, because pathway is there. DC is the way that I have, this is the way nurses has done the things according to the clinical guideline. You don't have to repeat these things on the wall again on the BHT. So this is the printed note. So you know what has been there. What have you done as a nurse? So this is easy way. This is in the printed form in the BHT. That is a way of documentation. So we have talked about so many different kinds of documentation methods and what are the purposes of the documentation and everything. So these are about this comprehensive care plan. Comprehensive care plan means, of course, the full BHT or your full care plan consists these things. Computerized documents or your admission sheets or whatsoever, you have written this. This document. And what else? Flow sheets. What else? Nurse's progress note. Discharge summary.
These four documents combining make a full comprehensive care plan of the patient. It is not the nursing care plan. This is comprehensive care plan. Comprehensive. What are the elements of comprehensive care plan? Computerized documents means in Malaysia. It's on the Malaysian book. That is why it says computerized document. What is our document? Computer. Written document of the admission and everything. That is the form. Then, flow sheets. Medication chart, input, output, temperature, whatever. Observation, those charts. Nurses progress notes. Of course, what we are attaching, nurses progress notes. Finally, discharge summary. Discharge summary should be written by a nurse, not by a doctor.
That is why. These four elements consisted made a comprehensive care plan. These are the four elements. That's why it says computerized documents, the demographic data and everything. It is there in the admission sheet. We are not computerizing them. The reason why this computerized documentation is there, because in Malaysia it is there in your Malaysian book. So when you come into the Sri Lankan context, this is also a written one. But we have computerized generating one document, the admission sheet from the admission place. It is computerized one. If the name is different, what we are telling them to go and fix the name and come, because it is a computerized document. These are the things. In other countries, allergies and everything which comes on the computerized document, on the admission sheet, everything comes with computer printed ones. But in our setting, we are writing it. Only the demographic data comes by the printer. Admission number, name, age, admission date and time, address, guardian's address, phone number. Those are the things that comes. These are the flow sheets as we have discussed before. Nurses progress notes. What we are writing, client's condition, problem and complaints, interventions which we have done, client's responses to interventions, achievement of outcomes. This is, of course, the nurse's progress note or the care plan. This is discharge summary. At the moment of the discharge, what is the status of the patient and admission and discharge status of the patient. What was the status when the patient got admitted? What was the status when the patient is discharging? And the brief summary of the client's care. You can't write each and everything. You can write this patient was diagnosed like this. So the medical management was gone like this and the nursing management was like this. And this much, what you call, medications given. Finally, the patient is demonstrating these kind of things and patient was discharged at this time. And follow-up details, follow-up things, revisit after 1 week with the blood, what you call, investigations or anything. Those things has to be written. That is discharge summary. Now, talking about trends in documentation, these are the trends. These are the new things which comes to our nursing, right? To our nursing care. When we are using our nursing process into this practice, these are the new trends in nursing, right? Minimum data set, nursing diagnosis has been different. nursing interventions has been classified, nursing outcomes has been classified. This is what I have mentioned as the computerized thing. Because when we are writing the nursing diagnose, we might not know about the proper words. Because do we remember all the Nanda nursing diagnoses? No. Every day we are using few of them. Self-care deficit, anxiety, nutritional imbalance, sometimes inadequate nutrition, what else? Breathing problems, what we are writing? Ineffective breathing pattern. Those things are the most prominent things that we are writing in our daily basis. But there are so much more diagnoses that can be done to a patient according to each and every component in health. Because you know, Nanda diagnose has been divided according to the elimination, nutrition, sleeping pattern, dietary pattern and everything. Can you remember? That is the way. But are we using at least one of each component?
No.
We are using same old 5 or 6 nursing diagnoses that we are having in our mind. It is because our memory capacity is not that much higher to remember all the Nanda diagnoses. If we know what are all these Nanda diagnoses, we might put those diagnoses to this patient and we might provide the care according to the diagnosis. So now the latest trends are to give more diagnoses to the patient from our memory. Right? That is a way, that is a trend. But what we are doing in this here is we are using latest technology. Those are the new trends in nursing. New trends come with the updated technology. Are we using updated technology in Sri Lankan nursing care? No. But in global nursing setting, nurses do more than what we think. Because machines are there. And all the resources are available. Latest technology is there. Everything is on your fingertips. So no need to fill up your brain with all these things. Minimum data set means demographic services and nursing care, the elements that should be contained in clinical records and abstracted for studies on the effectiveness and cost of nursing care. This is mainly focusing minimum data set means now we are not going to write all these irrelevant data in our nursing records. What we are going to write is the demographic data of the patient. I mean, these are the trends. These are now newly being invented, not still practicing, right? Only the demographic data and the services which was provided to the patient, not only the nursing. Separating the nursing into other levels, what are the services? MLT is a service. Medical laboratory technician is giving his service. When we are taking x-ray, x-ray is a service. Radiography, that is a service. When we are taking this physiotherapy, that is a service. So what we are going to do is write about all the services which the patient has received. And then document all the nursing care which the patient has received. Then it's gonna be cost, because in the world nursing is not free. Nursing care is all about business. Nursing care is all about business because according to the demand, nurses are providing the supply. Nursing care is a supply, it's a service, and services are based on the cost and money. So it is not about local nursing that we are getting a salary and providing our care. In the other world, in the other countries in the world, it's all about cost. It's all about cost analysis. So patient might see the cost of the mouth care first, rather than getting the mouth care. Each and every procedure has its own cost. For an X-ray, how much? For a skull X-ray, how much? For an abdomen, how much? And how much you're gonna pay for the radiographer for the reporting? X-ray is something different from the X-ray report. X-ray report means radiographer has reviewed the X-ray and given a report. That is, of course, another cost. And for a cannula, how much we have to pay? Is it necessary to put a cannula or to get an IV drip? Because once we got this minimum, the word minimum comes, that means we are not going to write irrelevant things. Demographics, services, and the nursing. That's it. So the BHT will be really reduced. Every time when we are measuring the temperature, it will be added to the patient's bill. Using a thermometer is also another service of cost. When the room cleaning comes, it is also cost. So basically the nursing and the healthcare is turning into business in the future of this world. So you won't have time to write. Everything is just like the menu.
If for a special mouth care, how much? For a normal mouth care, how much? So the patient is always depending on the cost.
That is why we have this minimal data set in nursing. So you know what is the demand and what is the money that you are going to gain. If the patient is receiving oral care by our forceps, it is much more higher. If he is brushing the teeth with toothbrush and when we are helping them, it is another cost. So minimum data set means we are not writing irrelevant things. It is, everything is service based. Each and every procedure has been categorized. The things what we are writing on the BHT is the demographics of the patient and what are the services that he has received and what are the nursing services or the care or the specific procedures that we have done to him on daily basis or shift basis or weekly basis. So it is up to the patient to receive the care or to go home. So minimal data set is another trend. So the patient don't have to pay more and stay more for things that it is not needed to him. He might choose, I want an X-ray and I want this. If the doctor says you should get a CT scan, he might find a hospital with lower cost to do a CT scan. He won't stay in the same hospital to get a CT scan because the CT scan is higher. Everything is about costing in the world in the future. So minimal data set will come. So we don't have to write each and everything because it is not the usual nursing care. It is somewhat different because we are giving it
according to the demand of the patient.
But in Sri Lanka public sector, we are not like that. In public sector, daily it's our duty to give mouth care to the patient because we are always concerning about patient's health. In near future, it is health plus business. This turning. That is why these trends are coming. Nursing diagnosis, of course, computerized nursing diagnosis will be actual or potential health problems or life responses. These trends can be changed because nursing diagnosis has to be changed. These are none the diagnoses. Only few what we are using at the moment. But there are a whole lot that we are not using. So these things are coming back into the nursing career now. That is a new trend. Actually, this is not a new trend. This was invented long time before, but it is not practicing. Now it comes to the practice with the latest technology. Because all the nursing diagnoses are there. You don't have to remember each and everything. What you have to do is touch and select. Nursing interventional classification. As the same way I have explained you before. For each diagnosis there are thousands of interventions which you can do. It is up to the patient to select which interventions that he prefers. Whether he prefers cool mattress for hypothermia or he prefers a tepid sponge. It is up to the patient. So we have this intervention classification. Nursing outcome classification. A classification system that comprises 190 outcome labels and corresponding definitions, measures, indicators and references. There are so many ways to write the outcome as the same way of intervention. Outcomes are there. You can't write, they won't pay you if you have written or if your procedure is finished by reducing the temperature from 100 to 99. They won't pay you for that. Because the latest trend is there are a standard outcome that should be there. It may be 98 Fahrenheit. That is outcome. So if you are unable to bring the patient into that outcome, it might not be effective. This outcome classification means there are about now 190 standardized outcomes. Outcomes has not been standardized at the moment. Have you ever heard about standardized outcomes? No. Now it is another trend. Standardized outcome has been there. Those days what we had was standardized nursing diagnosis. That is number. And we had standardized interventions to do. Now standardized outcomes has been there. Those are the latest trends which the Malaysian books are telling to us. So it's up to you to go and find what are these 190 standardized outcomes which the patient can get. These are the last slides are about almost about few of the other kind of nursing records. We have this summary report. Are we practicing summary reports? This is commonly given at end of shift. Just like our giving over, handing over book. This is a summary report. You can call the giving over, handing over book as a summary report, but we are not writing, the full details of the patient, right? It is almost all the significance points only that we are writing on the handing over, giving over. We have something called a summary report that even at the end of every shift, we have to give a report to the other nurse regarding what has happened in the shift to the person. This is a standardized name of a record, summary report. In other countries, there are things called as summary reports. Walking rounds. There are standardized reports which are called as walking rounds when we are doing what we are doing in the morning. Are we writing, documenting anything at the ward round? No. But there are standardized notes called as walking rounds, which is a reporting method used when the members of the care team walk to each client's room and discuss care and progress with each other and with the client. When we are having this morning walking ward rounds, there's a report to write. Because nursing in charge is there, ward sister is there, all the nurses are there, and even the patients are also there. So you can discuss what is going on and what are the difficulties the patient is having. So that is another summary kind of thing that is called walking rounds reports. Telephone reports. Of course, telephone reports means we don't have these reports, but all our telephone lines are being recorded. Is it? Is that so? In the hospital, all the telephone lines are recording, right? To maintain the confidentiality or about these outside calls and everything. It is there. Because in a hospital, the phone lines should be recorded because hospital is not a place to enjoy because everything is legal in that place. Sometimes people might threat through phones, maybe to healthcare professionals or maybe to patients. So all the phone lines are one recording. That is why we have this telephone reports and orders. Report transfers, communicate referrals, obtain client data, solve problems. That is what we have, this telephone communication. Can you remember we are writing when we are unable to contact the VP, it is a must to write it, unable to contact. If the phone line is busy or those things, you have to write. Why? If something happens, the problem might turn into yours. Your responsibility is to inform it to the responsible VP or the doctor. That is nurse's responsibility. So if you are unable to contact him, please do not miss it. Write it at the moment. Phone line is busy or unable to contact. Otherwise, so much problems might come to your side if he missed something or if something has happened to the patient. So these are like that, telephone and reports and orders. Incident report, this is on practice in our setting. Incident reports, it's with us. That is also legal kind of records. If any kind of incident has happened in the ward, you have to write it. What is the standard form or something for the incident record? Do we have? Yeah, it's something. I don't remember it exactly. Incident report. There are steps to be written. What do you call as an incident in the ward? Anything which has, fallen from anything which has make an injurious situation to the patient. That is called as an incident. So those are there. That is the most awaited slides for you all. I know that is the end of the lecture. And we'll discuss about, because lectures are something different. What we need, your focus should be on your assignment. So your assignment will be discussed on 28th. 3:20. So I'll finish the lesson now. If you got any problem, you can ask it now or you meet me later. Is everything clear to you? Yes. Okay. Thank you.